This is a South African beach daisy. To be precise, this is how it looks in Australia, where it's considered a common coastal weed. It was introduced here in the 1930s and in less than 100 years has taken on a rather new form.
The leaves are different, the way the stems grow is different, the flowers are different, everything about them is different.
Professor Angela Mulls wanted to be sure this was a case of rapid evolution. Her team tracked down the parent population in South Africa, collecting seeds to grow alongside Australian-sourced seeds in a rooftop glasshouse at UNSW Sydney.
Now, the seeds were made in different conditions, right, because they were grown in different countries. So we did another year of work just growing them through one generation in the glasshouse to take out the effects of that maternal environment.
She describes the result as astonishing.
I thought we might see a few changes, but I wasn't expecting anything like that scale. It shows that these plants are capable of changing much more quickly than we realized at first.
The team even forced the two to cross-pollinate, but that resulted in relatively low germination. So if the plants were growing next to each other in the wild, Professor Mulls thinks they would drift apart into separate species. Understanding how plants evolve has become her lifelong obsession. So much so, she once embarked on an ambitious global expedition collecting data from 75 different ecosystems.
There were deserts, there were rainforests, there was, you know, shrublands and savannas, everything everywhere. In each of these places, I studied how much the plants were getting eaten by animals. So this could be by mammals or by little insects and things.
And that matters because of a long-held assumption that interaction with animals was a key reason for greater diversity of plant species in the tropics.
I found that plants aren't any more likely to get eaten by things if they grow in the tropics. And we'd also assumed that plants had stronger chemical and physical defences against the animals if they lived in the tropics. And that turned out not to be true either.
One thing is true. As the global climate changes, plant species are migrating and evolving to suit new conditions. But even with this, things aren't straightforward.
Interestingly, different plant species are moving at different speeds, and they're not all going in the direction you'd expect. So you'd expect plants to be moving uphill or to the south, where it's cooler. But about 15% of the species that we look at in both studies are moving in the opposite direction, and we don't really know why.
But unanswered questions never deter Angela Mulls. She's proud to be recognised as a leading woman in science with the Nancy Millis Medal.
It has been a difficult time to maintain my research momentum as my kids were young. It's so nice to receive this award.